I'm sorry I didn't attend your funeral, Mom. I can't believe I missed my mom's funeral because I was in jail for a false accusation of thievery. I'm such a loser. I think I can't go any longer in life. I'm so depressed. There's no hope for me.
Hey, I couldn't help but hear what you said. Don't say that. You still have your whole life ahead of you. I know you're in one of the most hardest times of your life right now, but you mustn't give it up and still continue life while you still can. Look, I know a story of a guy who was in the same situation as you. His name was Oliver Gray. Once upon a time, Oliver Gray sat on the edge of the narrow bed and looked through the bars of his cell. He's been having the same thought in his mind for days now, and that thought was, why did no one believe me? Oliver had grown up in a rough neighborhood with gangs when crime was a way of life. For instance, people were drinking illegal substances. And they were also smoked in restricted areas. Despite this, he had never broken the law and had seen education as his way out of the inner city slums. So how he ended up in such much trouble? It had all started when he began his new job at Olive Green, the investment bank. Oliver's life was all work and no play. One day, his boss Mulligan said to him,
"You're invited to my party this weekend that will be attended by important clients."
Of course, Oliver accepted the invitation. The party was at Mulligan's mansion. Oliver was led inside by a butler. There he saw men in expensive suits and women covered in diamonds chatting together. He even passed by a cop that was patrolling the party. Oliver got very uncomfortable when surrounded by so much wealth. And he had nothing to say to the other guests. He wondered where Mulligan was. He saw an ajar door and wondered whether Mulligan would be there. He stepped inside. Suddenly, Oliver made a loud gasp. He did find Mulligan, but he was lying on the floor, covered in blood. He went closer. And that's when Oliver made his big mistake. Without thinking, he picked up the knife. And he observed the knife with fear still in his face. When suddenly... This is when Oliver's world starts crumbling down. At the very moment, a woman entered the room, saw one dead man and another holding a knife. She pointed her finger towards Oliver and screamed,
"Murder! Killer! Help!"
The woman's scream drew attention from the other guests. In an instant, a massive crowd formed in front of Oliver. Oliver looked around wide. He could read everyone's expression, and from there he knew that they thought he was the killer, since he was still holding the knife. Oliver told them that it wasn't him, but nobody believed him. They thought that he was lying. He couldn't stand it and blurted out,
"No! Please, stop!"
Oliver wanted to explain, but before he even could, someone interrupted him. The call from earlier came rushing towards Oliver. One of the guests had alarmed the cop regarding the incident.
"Stay back, or I'll blow your head off."
The sudden reaction from the cop froze Oliver. With shock and terror building up inside, Oliver wasn't able to explain himself. That day, he was brought to the court and was found guilty for the murder of his boss. He had been falsely accused. The reason to this was not only was he caught holding the weapon, but because he was known to grow up on the wrong side of town. Because of his background, he was falsely accused for a crime he didn't commit. Several years had passed and the real killer was finally caught. Oliver got out of jail, but he was already 54 years old at the time. He knew he had only a short time of his life left to enjoy, since most of his has been taken away from him. Despite everything, he didn't give up. He tried making the most out of his short life. He found the love of his life and even made campaigns and voiced out regarding the miscarriage of justice that happens in the country to spread awareness about it. Before passing away, he said that he was glad that he was able to live the rest of his life to its fullest. So if I could go on in life, so can you.
Wow, I really needed to hear all that. Wait, did you say I? Old man, where do you go? I didn't get to thank him. Your story truly inspired me. Thank you, Oliver. It was really nice meeting you.